Hello guys, welcome back to the channel, welcome back to the garage, welcome to an alright day here in Pennsylvania. I think this whole week's supposed to be rain, so we're going to try and get this task out of the way today, because we might not be able to work out here in the driveway on the second gen for probably the whole week. Yeah, it's supposed to be pretty bad. So anyhow guys, today we were working on the second gen, and today we were doing like probably the second most noted, or I had put out an Instagram post and, you know, our first, you know, video on this truck, that there was two modifications that trumped all the modifications that everybody told me to do. The first is to P-pump the truck, which is not going to happen, at least not anytime soon. I'm not saying down the road a ways, that's not a possibility, but it's not going to happen right now. We're going to see what this VP44 life is all about. But the second one was fuel system. So an inherent problem with these trucks is the lift pump. So on this particular truck, and I think some of the later ones actually had electric pumps like you see today. I'm not sure when that switch occurred, but this particular truck originally, and I don't think you'll be able to see it, came with a mechanically operated pump that fed into our fuel filter canister and then eventually into our VP44. So those pumps are notorious for going bad over time and just slowly getting out less and less pressure, and then you're not providing fuel pressure to the VP44, which needs to have that 15 pounds constantly, otherwise it kills it. So that, you know, it's kind of an inherent thing with these. The injection pump can go kaput because you don't have the fuel pressure that you need. So this truck actually has a fuel system on it already. It's not one that I want on it. I want something that I know and I trust, just to make sure everything is right with that VP44. So that is why we got with the guys at AirDog to provide the fuel system for this truck. As you guys know, we trusted an AirDog on this truck, which got it to 1,000 horsepower and a 10-19 1/4 with a CM2200 ECM, which is quite the feat. And now we have it on the race truck in a filter and air separator fashion. So we like the AirDog stuff on our trucks, you know, trusting them to filter it for the, you know, two 12 mil CP3 pumps and our big injectors on this truck. So for our 24 valve, we got their 165 4G pump. So in the box comes with everything you need, from your draw straw to your mounting brackets, all your fittings, all that kind of stuff, your harness, and then of course your pump assembly and filters, instructions, a nice little sticker. Also, they switched to a black hose, which is pretty nice. And here's probably the most important thing for you guys, the warranty registration card. So these pumps come with like a lifetime warranty, and that is awesome. You just got to make sure you send this thing in and get that all validated. Now with that, when you're buying one of these, make sure you go to like an authorized dealer, all that. Don't go to Amazon or eBay and get it for, hey, $50 cheaper, because that voids your warranty because you have bought it under the MAP pricing. So all their pumps have to be sold at least, you know, whatever the price is, unless there's an official like AirDog sale going on, which there is. I'm not affiliated with the sale at all. I just figured I'd let you guys know. Until the end of this month, May 2020, they have like a 10% off on all their pumps. So go check them out. Go, like I said, I don't have a code or anything like this. Just figured I'd let you guys know. Typically you only see these things go on sale like Black Friday time frame. So now's your chance to get one here in early spring for cheaper. So like I said, everything you need to put the AirDog in comes in a box, but we are going to be doing things a little bit differently. So to truly do this without like dropping the tank, which I actually recommend dropping the tank just so you can clean it all out, make sure everything's good inside of there and all that, I like this GNR diesel sump. I actually have this on Caitlin. I had it on the race truck when we were still running a normal fuel tank. So I like this. This is the first dual port sump that you can get. When I was actually looking for this again, I've seen that there's a lot of copycats on the market now. GNR is the first one I had ever seen, so that's why we're going with them. They actually even upgraded the product a little bit, because my original one didn't have the return and the feed, you know, logos there. I guess that's, what's the S? Yeah, supply and return. My original one didn't have that. So anyway, these things are great. It's just two bolts with copper washers. They have a drain on them. They're just a great design. I have not had any problems. I really recommend this GNR. There's other cheaper ones out there, and I wouldn't trust them not to leak. These things are robust, and the machine quality is fantastic. But once again, everything you need, you know, you got AN fittings or, you know, barbs, which we will be using the barbs, and the correct size hole saw. And to go along with all this, we have a block off plate. So we are going to actually be deleting the factory fuel bowl and the factory lift pump, as well as the lift pump that's currently on it, just because I want a cleaner engine bay, get that stuff out of there. It's not doing anything. And whoever put the fuel system that's on it, actually, where is it here? Yeah, they blocked off this one banjo bolt. I don't know if you guys can see that, with a just a bolt through it. Yeah, not the right way to do that, you know. But we're gonna get rid of all that crap and kind of clean it up. So anyway, our first task at hand is to try and empty the fuel tank, because this thing has like half a tank of fuel. So yeah. All right, let's get started and get the fuel out of here and get the fuel tank out and see how cruddy that thing is after 22 years. See if we can make a pass. Ooh. All right, so we are draining the fuel out of the second gen into Caitlin. Basically just pulled the supply line back and then I fed it into the filter neck on Caitlin. Now when you turn the key on this, it just bumps the pump for a second. It won't start, I guess, unless the thing's running. So we had to kind of bypass that and fool the relay, just put 12 volts to it. So while that's going on, we're actually going to start trying to pull our fuel filter housing and our lift pump out. I can just listen to it, and when I hear the tone change, I'll know that the tank is getting empty. Caitlin is at about a quarter tank, so we should be good volume wise. But yeah, let's get this whole little filter thing out and clean up this engine compartment, not interior. So we got our fuel successfully drained out of the tank and into Caitlin. Got the tank out, not really a big deal, just kind of have to unhook stuff. We also got the old fuel system off of here. It was just one with a filter. It's not like our Air Dog that has the filter and the water separator. So this is definitely a nice upgrade. But we also got rid of the factory supply line. because we don't need that. We got our nice big black hose, and also got rid of the factory fuel filter housing and full lift pump. So like I said before, I had actually said that this was mechanical. I guess on the 12 valves it is. This is actually electrical, but it does get mounted over the hole in the block right down there. I don't know if you guys can see that. Right there in the block, we have our block off plate installed. Looking good, really just getting rid of some of the clutter in here from that stuff we're not using anymore. I forgot to tell you guys earlier, when you are taking out the old part of the fuel system, the old fuel bowl or fuel filter housing, you've got to find some shorter bolts to replace these. Otherwise you will have a massive, well, not massive, whatever size bolt that is, M8, whatever. You'll have that much air coming out because those holes go directly into that intake horn area. So So on our VP44, I have our air dog fitting installed, the quick disconnect. I have that installed there. We got to take the tank apart, pull the sending unit out, clean the tank, see how that all looks, and then modify the fuel basket and all that for our GNR sump. And then we will get to installing our air dog, which we have to put our fittings in and all that. Also got to get the air dog mounted on the frame. Now, we did have one unexpected issue, and it's actually probably something I should have thought about. So when we pulled our fuel tank straps, this front one is certainly getting a little thin. It should be replaced. I pulled the one off of Moby Dick, hoping, but as you guys can see, it's a little short. So gonna have to get a new one of these. Not that that's a big deal. That can be done, when we have the tank installed. I can always put it in with this and change it out when one comes in. The rear one, it's in perfectly good shape. So we're gonna go back with that. So we'll get our tank cleaned up. We'll pull that fuel basket out and all that, and just get everything cleaned up so we can get our air dog installed on the truck. All right, so we got our tank all situated. What we did here was I actually capped off this one line. There was this fitting from the previous fuel system that I couldn't get off. So just cap that off because our return is actually gonna go to the sump. The factory one will still return through here, but this GNR one, it will be where our air dog return is returning to. So we'll just go to the bottom. Not a big deal. Also, as you guys can see, I chose to put our GNR sump up a little further. Normally I put it under the fuel basket in the common rails, but if you guys can look at our tank, it's seen better days. So it's curved up pretty good here. So I didn't want to run into the issue of, this curve and where it's flattening out. So I just went to the flat spot in the center of the tank. I think everything will be fine. I know on Caitlin I have it off-centered a little bit, but anyhow, we also put a little block off here for the filler neck because that's where the old system returned to. So the tank is cleaned out pretty good. There's still some fuel in there. So I did put some caps on our GNR diesel sump because try and limit that, but they're leaking a little bit. But when we get our lines and all on there, it won't be a big deal. So anyhow, our underside is ready to go. With our air dog all mounted up, looking good. So I mounted the air dog at the top of the bracket. The bracket kind of sandwiches the frame. I did have to drill through the frame for this bolt, but we have it up as high as it can go. I really, the old thing used to be, you'd always see filters. Everybody's filters hung down below the frame. Like, you could see them from the side of the truck, and I always irritated me. So with this AirDog bracket, you're able to actually get it up right up against the bed. So very happy with how that all played out and, you know, worked. So we got a good spot here. You know, we can put our all our lines and stuff on our AirDog. So now we'll get the tank back in, we can get our electric and our lines ran, and we will be ready to we'll be ready for fuel. I mean, we don't have any fuel, but we'll be ready for it. So guys, it is actually the following evening. Last night we were working on the truck, trying to get our AirDog all installed, and I kind of got to the point where all we had to do was our wiring and our plumbing. So after I got the fuel tank in and up, I started to do that stuff, and I just got to a point and said, you know what, that's enough for tonight. We'll finish this up tomorrow when I get home from work. So that's what we did. We ran all of our electric and our plumbing today. And yeah, that's where we had some issues. So first things first, we have a couple pig mats out back here because we have a bit of a mess. Yeah, so tried to start the truck and I had fuel leaking. I said, oh no, you know, my sump's in wrong or something, you know, was my immediate thought. But then again, that doesn't make any sense. I filled it up with fuel and it wasn't leaking. Yeah, so like I said, it was getting late. I put the tank in and I never hooked up the return. So the factory return was spewing fuel all over the top of the fuel tank and all over the ground. Now, if we move to the front of the vehicle, we have a puddle down below as well. So like I said, once again, it was getting late. I was getting tired. Our fuel fitting right there, going into the VP44. Yeah, I didn't have that clipped all the way in. So I had put that on there and started like from the front here to move to the back and with the plumbing. And yeah, I just never clicked that thing in all the way. So trying to start the truck, making a mess. So we have a couple little messes. It's not a big deal, but yeah, that's what happens sometimes. You get tired and you want to kind of get the job done. You know what, I don't have that much more to do. Well, if we would have kept going last night, we'd probably be redoing our wiring and plumbing because I just wouldn't have done a great job at it. So everything is done now. Our electrical is all in. We have our relay here mounted to the firewall. Everything's ran down with all the factory wiring. Comes up and it's actually connected in here to the fuse block. So our wiring's all good. Oh, our plumbing is good. Our AirDog is mounted on the frame. There's our GNR diesel sump. There is the leaking fuel from the return, I forgot, but our AirDog's up in there. And man, you know what? This 4G pump is so quiet by comparison to the one that we had. That pump that was on here when I was filling Caitlin up, it was just so noisy. Well, when you try and start this truck and the fuel pump stays on, you can hear the 4G and it's just, wow, it's just like a whisper by comparison. So anyway, the truck now starts right up. Okay, maybe not. Just listen to that. Quiet. There we go. Thank you. So anyway, guys, we got our fuel system installed on the second gen. We just got a couple messes that we made, but it is a second gen Cummins. I'm pretty sure that's what they're supposed to do, is leave little stains all over the driveway and whatnot. But anyway, in all seriousness, we got our air dog installed. Big shout out to those guys. All with our GNR diesel sump. Like I said, there are some cheap sumps like that GNR one on the market. GNR is the first ones that came up with it, at least that I knew of, and the quality is fantastic. It's just a robust unit. I really do like those sumps. That's what I have on Caitlin. That's what we used to have on the race truck and all that. So we got our fuel system installed. We got more stuff on the way. We're gonna keep rocking and rolling on this second gen. Like I keep saying, I'm very excited about this project, and I think the world's starting to open back up, so maybe we'll get to play with her a little bit this summer. So anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed. Please like the video, subscribe to the channel. Catch you guys on the next one. Get out in your garage, get the wrench in on your truck.